Yes, induced sputum has been standardized in terms of methodology and technique, and after the standardization has been used a lot to detect re-inflammation, in particular eosinophilic inflammation in asthma, and then to phenotype the disease. That is the most important aspect of induced sputum in asthma. But more recently has been evaluated the importance of induced sputum and the phenotype re-inflammation also in COPD. We have reference values, we have a very well standardized technique, and so it's very useful to detect re-inflammation and to monitor the disease. It's very useful because it's a very non-invasive, easy to use, in particular to monitor the disease. Also for children, in this particular type of patients, the use of induced sputum is quite difficult. Instead, the use of nitric oxide is very easy. The problem is that nitric oxide is not able in detecting many times the neutrophilic inflammation. It's very well correlated with the eosinophilic inflammation, but in asthma and COPD we have also neutrophilic inflammation, and sometimes it is impossible to monitor this type of inflammation with nitric oxide. Yes, it's very useful because it is a very, very non-invasive, very simple to detect, and has been very, very well studied and evaluated in asthma, because there is a very good correlation between the eosinophilic inflammation and blood eosinophilic inflammation in airways and the blood. The problem is that sometimes in COPD there is not a strong correlation between the eosinophilic inflammation in blood and in the airways. And so this is a limit, but the opportunity to detect re-inflammation in a very, very simple method, like the blood analysis, I think that this technique probably will be the future. The major limitation is that the airway diseases, asthma, both asthma and COPD, are different pathogenesis. The mechanism beyond asthma and COPD are very complex, and so to think that just one biomarker can explain the disease is impossible. I think that we must absolutely use more biomarkers to evaluate the different aspects of the disease.